A very warm welcome to all the students of Thakur Vidya Mandir High School and Junior College. Keeping up with our motto, let learning be a joy and teaching a pleasure. Here we are with remote teaching and learning process to bridge the gap. Happy learning, students. Welcome to all the students of 8th standard. We have already completed Unit 1 and from today we are moving ahead with our portion. So today we will start with Unit 2. If you all have any problems regarding Unit 1, feel free to ask me. Let's move ahead with Unit 2. Before we start with the topic, here is one story that I would like to tell you all, which will definitely lead to the topic that we are going to study today. So here is one boy whose name is Rahul. He is very punctual to school. He loves his parents, grandparents, relatives, and he is always happy-go person. He loves being around people. He loves to help everyone. But we see that Rahul is always disturbed on certain things. There are certain things in Rahul's mind which always disturbs him. And therefore, today we shall see what are the things by which Rahul gets disturbed. Oh, so here we are. We got to know his problem. Rahul is having a lot of problem regarding his career. He is confused which field to choose so that he can work on it. Even though Rahul is a small school-going kid, it is the right age and the right time to look and select the choice of a career. He sometimes thinks to become a lawyer. Sometimes he wants to become a doctor. Sometimes he thinks of becoming a pilot. And sometimes a baker. He is so confused and therefore this all thoughts are disturbing him. Similarly, the topic, the poem that we are going to study today is similar to a boy. The name of the boy is not mentioned in our poem, but the problem that is faced by Rahul, the same problem is been faced by boy in a poem. So today we shall study a poem from Unit 2. English Unit 2.1 Vocation by Rabindranath Tagore. Now you all must be thinking what is the term vocation? Vocation refers to an occupation for which a person is specially suited. So a vocation can be a call from anywhere so that it can change your entire life, so that it can help to choose a good career for your life. And therefore the term vocation refers to something suitable, something, a career which is suitable for you. Okay, so vocation, the basic meaning of vocation is, it refers to a job that is suited to you. Okay, the actual meaning of vocation, it is a call means not a call from anywhere, but a call for you to get ready for your career. So today we are going to study a new poem, okay, which is written by a famous poet, Rabindranath Tagore. Before we move ahead with our poem, I would like to give you all a background information about this poet. He is one of the famous poet, that is Rabindranath Tagore, and he was popularly known as Gurudev. The people around him used to call Rabindranath Tagore Gurudev. Okay, and we see that he was a great painter, a poet. poet, a playwright. He was a good storyteller. Okay, he was from the when he was small, from that very age, he started writing a lot of books. Okay, and Rabindranath Tagore, as a child, did not like to go to school at all, and so he was taught at his house. Okay, and since he was building up on his hobby, we see that he has written so many books. He was a good painter, and even he was working very hard for the people of India. Okay, he worked very, very hard so that people should realize about their culture, the Indian culture. Okay, and we also see that he won the Nobel Prize for Literature in 1913. Since he was so good in writing, and since he loved to write a lot, he wrote a lot of books. He was a good storyteller, and therefore he won the Nobel Prize for Literature in 1913. And he was a highly successful writer. And also, one of the most important thing about Rabindranath Tagore was that before India's independence in 1947, he also gave India its national anthem. So the national anthem that we sing in our school, Jana Gana Mana, was been given by Rabindranath Tagore. So the poem that he has written about vocation, okay, it is telling about his life. Okay, because remember, during those times, during Rabindranath Tagore's time, he did not like to go to school at all. We see that he did not like to go to school at all, and therefore he was taught at his house, and he had to face a lot of difficulties till he reaches a good stage. He To gain success, he had to face a lot of he was having a lot of lack of opportunities, lack of support, but still he started working on the tree. Then in this poem, he's talking about his own life as a child when he was small. Okay, even he was confused about his career. And during Rabindranath Tagore's time, he used to live in this four walls of his house, and therefore he did not get that type of exposure. And therefore, in this poem Vocation, he is trying to tell the minds of a small child what a small child thinks when he is given responsibility to think about his career. He wants that a child should get exposure. A child should know what exactly which career for him it is suited, rather than parents telling. The child himself should explore himself and then decide which career he wants to select. So similarly, our poem is also same about one small boy. Let's see what the poem is trying to tell us. Okay, so let's begin with the poem. Everyone, please open your English textbooks to page number 27. Vocation by Rabindranath Tagore. When the gong sounds 10 in the morning and I walk to the school by our lane, every day I meet the hawker crying, "Bangles, crystal bangles." There is nothing to hurry him on. There is no road he must take, no place he must go to, no time when he must come home. I wish I were a hawker, spending my day in the road, crying, "Bangles, crystal bangles." Okay, the speaker over here is a young boy. Okay, this poem is written by Rabindranath Tagore, but the speaker of the poem, the speaker over here is a young boy. Okay, and there is the name is not given to this young boy. Okay, And in this, before we go ahead, I just want you all to bring to a notice that Rabindranath Tagore's poem was a free verse. It did not have a particular stanza type thing. It was a free verse and a lot of narration in it. And so when we go through this poem, we will see there are a lot of narrations that are happening, and it is a free verse poem. Okay, so in the first stanza, not even a stanza, in the first free verse, let's see what message it is trying to tell us. But before that, let's move to the difficult meanings. I hope you all are having a pencil with you all. If you all don't have textbook, you all can screenshot this photo so that it will be helpful for you all during studies. So over here, the words that are marked bold, I'm going to tell you all the meaning of those words. First one is gong. A gong is a flat metal bell, okay, which draws attention of the people. So you all see, when a vegetable seller comes to your house, or anyone, or like you all can say fruit seller or vegetable seller, or people like this hawkers who come to your house, they have this small bell. So when you all hear this bell, you all know that, okay, so this hawker must have come, let's go and check what good he has brought for us. So gong meaning is that bell, okay. Then the other meaning, lane is you all can say a street road, a road, a narrow road, or a normal road, okay, a narrow road. And hawker is a person who travels selling his good. So the meaning of hawker is the one who sells his good. And the word crying does not mean that emotional crying that all human beings do. Crying over here means he is saying it loudly so that people can draw their attention towards him. So that cryingly, so that people know that he has come, and so that people can go and buy things. For example, if a vegetable seller comes, he will say it loudly. Like, for example, in Hindi, he always say, Kanda batata le lo, something like that. Okay, so over here in this first, you all can say first free verse, let's see what it is trying to tell us. The speaker is a young boy, as I have mentioned. At 10 o'clock every morning, when he is walking to school, he meets a hawker in his lane. So every day morning at 10 o'clock, when he goes to his school, when it is his school timing, we see that he meets a hawker in his lane. The hawker cries out, "Bangles, crystal bangles." The boy feels that there is nothing to hurry the hawker on. There is no fixed road he must travel by, no place that he has to go to, and no time when he must get back home. So in the first free verse, we see that the poem wants to become a hawker. Now he is very confused which career to choose in life, and therefore he thinks that he wants to become a hawker. He wants to become a hawker because he feels that the hawker can choose any road. He can go anywhere. He can take any path. He can come back home any time. And therefore, he wants to be a hawker. Remember, students, our parents always care for us. They love us, and therefore, they always guide us. And they tell us that when y'all finish your classes off, when you all come back home, use this particular road while coming home. Don't go by these streets. They don't restrict us, but they care for us. And therefore, this little boy feels that he is a lot restricted in his house, and therefore, he wants to be a hawker because he can go any path, he can take any road, he can go anywhere, he can come back home anytime. And even our parents tell us to come after playing on this particular time. so that and we obey them. They are not restricting us, but they are telling us for our good. So this little boy feels that his parents are restricting him, and therefore we see that he wants to be a hawker so that he can come anytime home. He can take any path, he can go anywhere, and so on. So we see in the first freeze verse what is the speaker, what is Rabindranath Tagore trying to tell us. Okay, so now let's move ahead. Let's see what more this child wants to be. Okay, let's move ahead. When at 4 in the afternoon I come back home from the school, I can see through the gate of that house the gardener digging the ground. He does what he likes with his spade. He soils his clothes with dust. Nobody takes him to task if he gets baked in the sun or gets wet. I wish I were a gardener digging away at the garden with nobody to stop me from digging. So now see, the speaker, the young boy, now wants to be a gardener. So when the boy comes back from the school at 4 in the afternoon, he sees a gardener digging the ground in nearby house. So while he was coming home from school, he just saw a gardener digging the ground, and now he wishes to be a gardener so that he sees that the gardener can do anything with the spade. Spade is a small tool, okay? It is a small tool with a sharp edge, okay? So the meaning of spade is a tool with a sharp edge. Over here, baked means heated, okay? And takes him to task means there is no one who can scold and correct him, okay? So now, why he wants to be a gardener? Because he feels that he can do anything with that tool. He can dirty his clothes, he can get wet and in the sun, but and no one will even shout at him. Often when we play outside and when we spoil our clothes and come back home, our parents tell us, so you spoil your clothes again. So maybe the child in the poem, he feels that always his mom shouts at him. So he is feeling so restricted home, and he can't do what he wants in life. And therefore now he wants to be a gardener so that he can spoil his clothes, he can do anything with his tool, and no one will even shout at him. Okay, often when we take any tool, equipment, or anything that will hurt us, our parents say, don't use that. It will hurt you. They are telling us for our betterment, but often we take them wrong. We feel that they are restricting us. No, my dear children, they are not restricting us. They care for us. And therefore, when we become big, you all will be able to know which tool is useful for which things. Okay, so now in the first we saw that the young boy wants to be a hawker so that he can take any road, he can come at any time back home, and now he wants to be a gardener. A small little child wants to be a gardener just because he wants to spoil his clothes, he wants to get dirty and so on, and he can enjoy his life by spoiling his clothes. He feels that, but he is not understanding the hard work that every occupation has. He is just thinking as a fun that, okay, if I become a hawker, I can take any road, I can come back home. But it takes a lot of time. These hawkers have to roam in this hot sun for us so that they can get some money. But as a child, he is thinking so cute and so nicely that, okay, if he can become a hawker, he can take any road, and if he becomes a gardener, he can spoil his clothes. Now let's move ahead. Just as it gets dark in the evening and my mother sends me to bed, I can see through my open window, the watchman walking up and down. The lane is dark and lonely, and the street lamp stands like a giant with one red eye in its head. The watchman swings his lantern and walks with his shadow at his side, and never once goes to bed in his life. I wish I were a watchman, walking the street all night, chasing the shadows with my lantern. So now this young boy wants to be a watchman because he feels that the watchman can walk up and down in the dark, lonely street. He can do whatever he wants. He can roam at night, he can do whatever he wants. And also, he sees that the street lamp, everyone has a street lamp. And that street lamp is symbolizes as a giant with one red eye in its head. So if y'all have observed your street lamps, it has just one light, and if you see the shadow of the lamp, you'll see that it is looking like a giant or a monster. And this one eye giant is referred to a character from Greek mythology who is having just one eye in that Greek mythology, in that story. And so that giant is referred to as the lamp, the street lamp. Okay, and now he wants to be a watchman so that he can do anything in the night. He can just walk and so on, chasing the shadow. The meaning of chasing the shadow means following an imaginary goal or target. You all know your shadow is always beside you. So it is telling us to chase the dreams that you want to desire, you want it in your life. So in this last paragraph, we see that this boy wants to be a watchman so that he can walk lonely in the street. He can do anything. He can go up and down. And he feels that the watchman never sleeps at all. And therefore, now he wants to be a watchman. So in this entire poem, three scenes of the day are mentioned. That is morning, afternoon, and night. Similarly, in our life, we have childhood. We have three stages. The first one is childhood, then middle, and then we get adult. But from the time we are born, okay, as we grow, we start thinking what we want to become in our future. We start thinking, okay, I want to be like my mother, I want to be like my dad, I want to be a teacher, doctor, and so on. It's very good to dream. We should always dream for something good so that it will be very useful for us. And therefore, in the last line, you see that I wish I were a watchman, walking the streets all night, chasing the shadows with my lantern. So that, as I have mentioned, that your shadow is always beside you. Okay? And therefore, he's telling us to chase the dreams that we are planning to do. Okay? And also remember, my students, this poem has been written by the famous poet Rabindranath Tagore. He is telling about this young boy. Is telling about this young boy who is longing for complete freedom. He wants to lead a carefree life. He wants freedom. He wants exposure. He wants a carefree life where he can think for himself. He can think which career is suitable for him. And therefore, he wishes now to be any of the three feels that okay, if I be a hawker, I can take any road. If I be a gardener, I can spoil my clothes. If I be a watchman, I can dirty my clothes. So Rabindranath Tagore's style or the structure, if you see, his poems are free verse and a lot of narrations. It is telling a lot of insights about the person, about a child, what all problems he is facing to choose a career. Okay, I hope you all understood this poem. If you all have any doubts, you all can ask me. Before ending up this video, I have a small activity for you all. The people you trust the most, it can be your parents, grandparents, friends, relatives, anyone. I want you all to discuss about your future plans and how are you trying to achieve your plan? What steps are you taking for the planning? How you are going to work out? Discuss it with your parents. See, you will get a lot of exposure. After 2 years, you all are going to be in 10th standard, and then you all will be so confused to select which stream, whether arts, commerce, science, or many more. So if you all start thinking from today itself, it will be very useful, and you all won't be like Rahul, who is confused about his career. It is fine if you all are confused, but make a way. Ask your parents about it. Talk to your parents about it. And last but not the least, each job that anyone does is very important. We should not disrespect anyone who is doing work which is you feel that, oh, he works as a watchman. No, my dear friends, the work of a watchman is so important. If there are no watchmen, we would have not get good sleep. And therefore, because of watchmen, we are getting good sleep. So always remember to greet such people, our watchmen, the vegetable sellers. Say hello, uncle. How are you, uncle? Good morning, uncle. Good night, uncle. The watchman who is there in your own building, at least greet him. Give him a smile. He will feel so happy. Try it, my dear friends. Any work, if it is a teacher's work, doctor's work, or the one who cleans our street, the ones who picks our dustbin, all work are important. If anyone will stop doing that work, it will have a lot of problem for us. I have given an example of watchmen. If there are no watchmen, then we won't get good sleep. If our streets are not clean, we will get this smell and we will get infected. So always respect all these people who are working. None of the work is small or big. Every work, all the work that everyone is doing is equal. Okay? Thank you, students. Have a nice day. Thank you. Stay safe.